Welcome friends, we will continue with the last lecture of glazing, loading, dressing and truing phenomena. Now, as we have studied, the glazing is appearance of glass-like structure around the periphery of grinding wheel, whereas loading is the phenomena of additional sticking of a material on the surface of the grinding wheel. Both are drawbacks of the grinding wheel, which loses the cutting ability of the grinding wheel, which reduces the efficiency of the grinding wheel. So we are improving the cutting ability of the grinding wheel with the help of dressing and truing operation. So whenever a grinding wheel becomes glazed or loaded or gone out of shape, then they are corrected by dressing and truing. Dressing means what? Dressing is the process of breaking away the glazed surface so that the sharp particles are again presented to the workpiece. So the common type of wheel dresser is a star dresser or a diamond tool dresser, which is used for this purpose. Star dresser consists of number of hardened steel wheels on its periphery. And now you can see the sketch also. Here it is shown. This is a grinding wheel which loses its cutting ability because of a glazing and loading phenomena. Now what happens? This grinding wheel is rotated at high speed, and a star dresser or a diamond dresser brought in contact with this grinding wheel, these sharp cutting teeth of the star dresser cut the dull surface around the periphery of grinding wheel, the glass-like structure has been appeared. So to break that glass-like structure, we are using this star dresser. So here, what happens to this star dresser? The dresser is held against the face of a revolving wheel and moved across the face to dress the wheel surface. This star dresser is particularly for a coarse or rough grinding wheel. Sometimes a diamond tool is also used, which is pointed down at an angle of 15 degree, and during this operation good amount of coolant is applied while dressing operation, and very light cut only may be taken with diamond tools. So what happens here? Once again we will observe here, whenever a grinding wheel is subjected to a drawback of glazing and loading, then this grinding wheel loses its cutting ability. So to improve its cutting ability and to break the glossy like surface around its periphery, it is brought in contact with the star dresser tool or sometimes diamond nature of tool. So there are two types of dresser: star dresser, diamond dresser. Diamond dresser has a sharp edge at the front side, whereas star dresser has number of cutting teeth around its periphery, which brought in contact with the rotating grinding wheel. What will happen? This star dresser or this diamond dresser cut the glossy like surface or removes the loaded material from the periphery of the grinding wheel, so that the surface becomes now a previous or a original surface of a grinding wheel. So you can see these are the sharp edges can be observed once again around the periphery after dressing operation. So you can do the dressing either by a star dresser or you can do it by diamond dresser. Only thing, a diamond dresser, you have to incline it at an angle of 10 to 15 degree so that you can remove the unwanted material from the grinding wheel. You can break the glossy like surface from the periphery of the grinding wheel, so that once again the grinding wheel will improve its cutting ability and it will cut the material. So this is one of the operation that we call it as a dressing. Then what is truing? Truing is the operation to bring the grinding wheel in concentric with the center of this or axis of this grinding wheel. It is the process of changing the shape of grinding wheel as it becomes worn from its original shape and leads to break away the bond and abrasive. Because of glazing and loading condition, sometimes the grinding wheel becomes in uneven shape or it is not a true circular shape, it is not showing a true circular shape. To bring the true circular shape of this grinding wheel, or the periphery of the grinding wheel, we have to bring it in a true sense or in a concentric with the axis of bore, then we are doing it with the help of a single point diamond tool, that we call it as a truing operation. So truing is nothing but a pointer. It is a single point cutting tool. It is brought in contact with the rotating grinding wheel so that the concentricity and the true diameter of this grinding wheel brought in a shape by cutting certain material. So diamond tool dressers are used at an angle of 15 degree or moved across the feed rate. You can remove the small amount of material at around 0.02 mm, and good amount of coolant is applied for the truing surface. Dressing and the truing, both are these phenomena which will bring the grinding wheel once again into active condition. Whereas dressing is the operation of breakage of a glossy like surface, whereas truing operation is bringing this grinding wheel in a true diameter or in a true sense, whose periphery we are bringing it in concentric with the axis of the bore. So this is a true diameter of grinding wheel. So this both we are doing it with the help of a tool that we call it as a diamond tool. So these are the methods to overcome the phenomena that is called as a dressing. The drawback of the grinding wheel, glazing and loading, can be overcome with the help of dressing and truing operation. Now, what is the next bit of this surface finishing chapter? Balancing and mounting of the grinding wheel. So, we'll see first of all what is meant by balancing of a wheel. Many times it happens that even if using dressing and truing operation, the grinding wheel sometimes it is not brought in a true sense or in a true diameter. It becomes, because of glazing and loading condition, it becomes unbalanced. When it becomes unbalanced through the continuous use of the grinding wheel, it becomes a wear. So because of this wear, that wheel becomes unbalanced. So because of this unbalancing, it does not only produce a poor workpiece surface finish, but it produces undue strain on a machine also. The unbalanced grinding wheel may affect on entire system of this grinding machine. So what happens generally, this grinding wheel is made in a balanced condition with the help of by filling certain lead material at the center position, where you can observe here it is a test mandrel above which a bush is added. Above bush, a grinding wheel is mounted. So this entire assembly is supported with knife edge, and now this around this test mandrel, this wheel is rotating and checking the for the balance. Sometimes large grinding wheels are also balanced by adding certain weight, or balanced by moving weight. Certain weights are added and then it is moved and checked whether it is in balance condition or out of balance condition. So generally grinding wheels, they rotate it at high speed, and the density and weight should be evenly distributed around the surface. So wherever you feel by observation itself, after rotating this grinding wheel, when you observe that this grinding wheel is in out of balance condition, at which surface it is showing unbalance, you can add the material. So you can add on the surface on from both sides, you can add the weight, and after adding the weight, then you can once again rotating this grinding wheel and checking for its balancing. So balancing is done. So wherever it is not possible by truing and dressing, then we are doing the balancing of wheel with the help of this unit, or with the help of this device, we can check the balancing of grinding wheel. what is mounting of the grinding wheel? So try to understand, generally grinding wheels are operating at very high speed, and it is essential to take the care of mounting of the wheel. Means before we are using the grinding wheel into actual operation, we must check the grinding wheel whether it is suited to fit for actual operation or not. So for that purpose, you see this picture, you can understand. This is the spindle whose one end is bolted with the help of a nut. It is tightened, and on the spindle a grinding wheel is mounted at the central place with the help of a bush. On the spindle a bush is fitted. Here you can observe structure, hatched structure, above which a grinding wheel is mounted. From both sides of the grinding wheel we are attaching the flanges, so that whenever we are operating the grinding wheel, it because of the centrifugal force at high speed, it should not come out from the assembly. That's why flanges are fitted with the help of nut and bolt assembly. From both side it is fitted. Obviously a washer is attached before attaching it to the grinding wheel on both sides of the grinding wheel surface. So what what we are doing, once we are mounting it, then we are rotating it and we are checking various parameters. What inspection we should do before for checking this wheel mounting, then just see one by one. All the grinding wheels should be inspected before the mounting to make sure that they have not been damaged. First of all, we are checking the grinding wheel. Is there any internal damage, or because of the material manufacturing, is there any internal damage to the grinding wheel? That we must check. Then the wheel is put on the arbor or the spindle, and it is subjected to certain hammer blows. Hammer blows means we are applying certain force with the help of hammer, and then we are checking whether any ringing or vibrating sound is observed or not. If it is yes, then it is okay. If it is not, then certain damage is inside the grinding wheel material. Then we will go for a next checking. Wheel should not be forced on. They should not be they have to be easily fit on the spindle. See here, before fitting on grinding wheel on this assembly, we should easily fit it on the lead bush. We should not force the grinding wheel to fit on this lead bush. That checking must be done. The whole of the grinding wheel is mostly aligned with the lead bush. Means the grinding wheel internal diameter axis and the lead bush axis must be concentric, must be aligned with each other. Lead bush is also a cylindrical in shape, hollow cylindrical shape. Grinding wheel is also a hollow portion. So that's why the concentricity must be there. The axis of this grinding wheel and the lead bush must be aligned with each other. There must be a flange on each side of the grinding wheel. So flange must be large in diameter. So generally the flange diameter is equal to the half of the grinding wheel diameter. So grinding wheel diameter, if suppose here it is the capital D large diameter, then flange diameter we are taking it as D/2. So it should be a large enough to hold the grinding wheel properly. It should not go out of balance. Next one step we have to follow, the sides of the wheel and the flanges should be flat, and the flanges contact the wheel only with annular clamping area. So here we are clamping this flange around the periphery, around the surface of this grinding wheel from both sides with the help of this clamping device. The inner flange should be keyed to the spindle, whereas outer flange should be easily slide fit. Means what? Here initially this on left side flange is provided, that is fixed on the keyway of the spindle, and right hand side this flange, you can observe this hatch portion, this flange we are fitting it with a slide fit around the surface of this grinding wheel. So on one side it is a fixed flange and another side it is a movable flange. Both are fitted on the both sides of this surface of this grinding.